top six to the main event. Josh Richards, Tim McCready, three championships between this front row. And they work out of turn number four for the green flag. Here we go. Shot by him like he was standing still. Brad Sangway up the banking. He lost a ton of real estate. Scott Greer, first car on the outside, looking in as it's Josh Richards all the way at the halfway point. It'll be halfway this time by Richards. Straightaway lead over the battle for second between McCready and Mars. Five in, five to go. Josh Richards dominating here tonight in the heat. Mars and McCready having a stellar battle. The MB Custom race car along with the 39 of the Warrior McCready. Richards down the front stretch already, and Mars and McCready stay side by side. What a great battle for the final redraw spot. Mars again to the inside of McCready. Now Balkan is starting to catch Morgan Bagley for the number four spot. Two to go when they come back by the line. And again, Mars has McCready for second. So T-Mac will go right back to work on the top side. Now he'll switch lines and go to the inside down the back stretch. Richards working on the 71 of Fawcett, slide job in four. White flag the next time by. Richards, Mars, McCready, Bagley, Balkan, and Tsang in the big dance right now. White flag is gonna wave for Josh Richards. One more time around. Jimmy Mars looking at a solid second and a redraw spot right now. Then it's T-Mac, Bagley, Balkan, and Tsang. Checkered flag's gonna wave. Heat number one is gonna go to Josh Richards. Here they come for second. It's gonna be Jimmy Mars. Third will go to McCready. Fourth is gonna go to Bagley. Fifth will go to Balkan, and sixth will go to Tsang. Then it's gonna be Scott Greer, first car on the outside looking in, Ward Emery, and the 71 of Rick Fawcett.
Rick Lowy to the announcer stand, please. Rick Lowy to the announcer stand. Well, we want to say a quick thank you to our Prairie Dodge dealers. If you're not sure who they are, they're Waverly Dodge, Eastern Sales, Goche Chrysler, Pemina Chrysler, Winnipeg Dodge, all in Winnipeg, Steinbach Dodge and Steinbach, Pemina Valley Chrysler and Morton, Portage Chrysler and Portage La Prairie, Brandon Chrysler and Brandon, and Murray Chrysler, also in Brandon. Extreme Coatings transforms your everyday into extraordinary. We specialize in reflex spray and truck liners. Full line of accessories, and now we have a complete sign shop. From company logos to complete vinyl wraps, we got you covered. Find us online at extremecoatings.ta.
All right, Pat, sounds good. As we get set for heat race number two, again, the same as before. 10 laps the distance. The top two will go to the redraw. The top six will go to the main event. If you finish seventh on back, you're going to go to the 12-lap last chance showdown. So word is over World of Outlaws radio system. Let's bring out heat number two, where we're going to find Eric Wells on the pole in the 18. Tim Fuller in 19, the 7 of Ricky Weiss, the one star of Chubzilla, Chub Frank. It's Bubba Cool in 57J, Mohawk Nation. You may get to see Bubba Cool's latest Mohawk. Yeah, wow. And we've got a prize for the best one tonight, I understand. Pat Doran, the 11, 9 of Steve Anderson, 71 of Stephen Snare, the 5E of Shane Edgington. Here we go with heat race number two. Eric Wells on the inside, Tim Fuller on the outside. Who's going to win the drag race into turn number one as we reach the VP Fuels firing line in turn four? Green flag is out. We're underway. Well, good battle going on for second. Wells pulls away. Weiss to the inside of Fuller for the redraw spot, and he'll take it away. Ricky Weiss goes to second early. Now Chubb and Bubba are battling side by side for the number four spot. It's Eric Wells in the lead. Ricky Weiss second, looking to go to the redraw. Tim Fuller, Chubb Frank. Bubba Cool is fifth, and Pat Norris sixth. Edgington, Anderson, and Snare on the outside looking in. Eric Wells, every racetrack he goes to that he's never been to before, he seems to just excel. Never has seen the place, never laid eyes on it, goes out there and does extremely well. And of course, first time ever in Winnipeg, why not go out here and win the heat? Ricky Weiss in that second and final redraw spot, looking to get a good starting spot in the feature tonight in his first ever Outlaw victory. I asked the crew today, didn't ask him, I asked the crew, what do you think? Can he do it? And they said, yeah, why not? That's why he's here. Makes sense to me. Chubb Frank's having a good run. Chubb started in the four spot. Right now working on third place, Tim Fuller. And Chubb Frank can't quite make the pass that time. We're halfway, 5 and 5 to go. It's all Eric Wells. So far, the heat races have been runaways. That's going to change in the feature with 24 cars out here. Well, Chubb Frank to the inside of Fuller now for the third spot. If you can finish third in this heat, you will start in the eighth position tonight, which isn't bad. And that's what they're battling for right now. The difference between 8th and 11th. And Chubb will clear the 19 and take over third. Two to go signal when Wells comes back by the next time. And Wells has got a comfortable lead. Now Bubba Cool starting to close the gap on Tim Fuller. We could have a protest here for the number four spot in just a moment. As your leader will see the white flag the next time by. Ricky Weiss is going to the redraw with no mistakes in these final lap and a half. Chubb Frank, Tim Fuller, Bob McCool, Pat Dar all in the show. Shane Edgington, right now, even if he doesn't transfer, will be on the front row of the last chance showdown if he can stay there in seventh. One lap to go for Wells. Pretty much a shoe-in at this point, as is Ricky Weiss. Wells working on Steve Anderson, and it's not going to matter to Anderson. As Checkered is going to come out, Wells wins it. Ricky Weiss is going to the redraw. Chubb Frank, if he can hold on, will finish third. Tim Fuller fourth. Fifth will go to McCool. Pat Gore's gonna come home sixth. It's last chance racing for Edgington, Anderson, and Snare. So two heat events in the books. Snare, Anderson, and Edgington will all go to the last chance showdown. Ricky Weiss is going to the redraw tonight. He's got a shot for the pole. As does your winner, Eric Wells, in the 18. So just one more heat to go.
First in local news, sports, and entertainment, the Winnipeg Sun. Start your day with the Winnipeg Sun. Pick up your copy and be the first to know. Proud sponsor of Red River Co-op Speedway. Rick Lowy, could we get you to the announcer's tower immediately? Rick Lowy to the announcer's tower immediately.
And we are at our third and final heat event. I'll tell you, Darren, what do you think so far? Racetrack is just about perfect for these guys. Been pretty exciting action as well.
Absolutely, these guys really getting a hold of the racetrack. It's amazing to see these travelers come up here and do such a great job in such short order. I mean, they get some hot laps and these guys are set up. I mean, you look at a guy like Ricky Weiss, a two-time Wizota champion, and second in that one, he did great, but I'm telling you, these top World of Outlaws guys are amazing.
Well, let's see what happens in this third and final qualifier. It's gonna be Darrell Lanigan on the pole in 29, Rick Eckert in 24. Clint Smith in the 44 and Shane Clanton in 25. Brady Smith in the 2. John Mason in 72. Bill Mooney in 2. And Cord Ellard in the 92. See as we get set for our third and final heat. Third and final heat set to come out of turn number 4 as we're gonna go green and take our final 6 drivers to the main event. Here we go. This may be the lowest of all the heats right here with Darrell Lanigan, Rick Eckert, Clint Smith, Shane Clanton, Brady Smith, John Mason, Bill Mooney. And they are running under a blanket right now up front with Lanigan and Eckert in the redraw spots. John Mason in the hot seat, 6th and final transfer spot. Bill Mooney, though, feeling it down low. He's going to go underneath John Mason, and Mason is now sitting on the outside looking in. So the Moon Man puts one over the 72 of Mason. Sharp machine, McPhillips Toyota Camry. That two is dialed in here right now, and he's going to set his sights on Brady Smith. Meanwhile, up front, it's all Darrell Lanigan all the time, as he leads Rick Eckert, our most recent winner on the Wild West Tour. He won at the Gillette Thunder Speedway in Gillette, Wyoming on Tuesday night. Lanigan, the winner at the Deer Creek Speedway for the Knapp Auto Parts Gopher State 50. So that's our last two winners right now running first and second. Halfway next time by. So we're halfway this time. 5 and 5 to go for Lanigan. Allard spins and caution is out. 5 in the books, caution is out for Cord Ellard. But you gotta think Mother Nature kind of throwing a curveball. No, it wasn't the R word, it was the S and W word, Pat. I mean, we've got sun, we've got wind, and it's tough to maintain not only a race track, but a race car as well to get to where you need to be. to make this thing happen. Sun and wind, you know, it's hard to deal with this kind of stuff.
It'd be as hard as turning on this wireless mic, I'm thinking.
That was harder. I think maintaining a racetrack might have been easier.
I got yours figured out. Now they give me Darren's. I'm starting like I'm a new guy they got to retrain or something.
No doubt about it. And it looks like Allard's fun meter is pegged. He's taking the 92C right to the infield. So maybe something wrong with the machine as Green comes out. So only one driver here is not going to make it into the main event. Who's that going to be? Whoever's in that last spot. Right now it's Mooney, but that could change. Darrell Lanigan bringing him out of four. So we are halfway officially now through heat number three, and Eckert and Clanton battle for the second and final transfer spot. Jay Clanton will steal it from Eckert. Now Scrub's gonna try and get it back. Oh, side by side and nothing doing. Shane Clanton has it. Now Brady Smith will work the inside of Rick Eckert. Eckert not able to keep the car planted, and it's costing him big time. Brady Smith will go to third. Seven go on the Pepsi scoreboard, two to go next time. And now Eckert's gonna work Brady Smith, but it's not gonna matter. John Mason sitting in the sixth and final transfer spot. Mooney on the outside looking in, white flag the next time by. Out of turn number four, Darrell Lanigan with a convincing lead. One to go, time running out on Brady Smith. If he wants the second and final redraw spot, he's got a chance. Shane Clanton now has opened up the door for the prodigy. Brady Smith to the inside. Second and final redraw spot is under protest, and Brady Smith has taken it away from Shane Clanton. Now Clanton will take a look to the inside. Checker flag goes to Lanigan. Here they come for second. Brady Smith is going to the redraw. Shane Clanton settles for third. Eckert fourth, Clint Smith is fifth. John Mason's gonna take home sixth, and Mooney will get seventh.
Well, the only heat race with a yellow flag, Rick, so pretty good racing throughout the three of them, just one yellow, and unfortunately caused by Cord Allard, who's a rookie in the class, but that's a tough break for, a good break for the 72 car, a tough break for the two car. Well, we have, what do we got coming up? I think we have our World of Outlaw feature redraw coming up. Well, while we got a minute, let's tell the people about our local Prairie Dodge retailers during the trade-in and trade-up event. We want you to get in and check out the 59 mile per gallon Dodge Dart for only $88 bi-weekly. Yeah, dart into your Prairie Dodge retailers and get into the new Dodge Dart, only $88 bi-weekly during their trade-in and trade-up sales event. Now, we want to remind you that the Junior Fan Club, you can enter that for free. The registration forms are at the Shirt Shack. You all